We're here at True North in part to help the new faculty as they begin their initiation into classical education. And we're very excited to be with them in part because my colleagues from higher education are taking great interest in K-12. Dr. Williams and Dr. Post both serve as fellows of the Institute. The schools here in Miami are doing remarkable work. Just got word that state tests came in and they just knocked it out of the park, as they say. But much more importantly, True North is committed to both intellectual, moral, and aesthetic development. Truth, goodness, and beauty, these are real things, and this school is determined to promote them. And so our time here at True North gives us a firsthand opportunity in the field to hear from teachers, to sit down and talk about the texts that matter to them as we prepare them to address their students.
And today, of course, most people will think that education is about simply getting a job. We go to school to get a job. So I wanted them to see that this is a tradition that has developed, that though it started in 5th century BC Athens with Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, it was handed on to the Romans. From there, it was handed on to the Christians in North Africa. And from these three Mediterranean traditions of the Greeks, the Romans, and the Christians, we get the beginning of this long tradition that we're all a part of now.
We really want to be able to tell the story of True North Classical and related academies because there are more than 800 nationwide, and their work is essential to the next generation.
During the seminars and the breaks, we had the opportunity to hear from some of the new faculty what attracted them to True North. Among the things that they said were that True North is a place where they feel like they can help cultivate in students a sense that what they're doing in life should be meaningful. They should aspire to make things that are beautiful, aspire to live a life of nobility.
Working with the schools will give us a chance to understand what is most needed by those teachers. And we will provide additional training in the years ahead.
I was able to share with them that the classical tradition has really seen and identified 6 ends: intellectual, moral, aesthetic, spiritual, practical, and physical.
In the work that we're doing, not only are we aspiring to understand better what it means to live a meaningful and flourishing life, but we're also trying to think through how we can model this, and model this as a way of life, and also model this as a way of teaching in the classroom and a way of being receptive and listening to and learning from each other.
Working with scholars like Dr. Post and Dr. Williams provides us the opportunity to make sure that K-12 education of a classical vein will be here today, tomorrow, and for years to come.